Okay, if you are watching this video, then you have not given up yet. So I realize that some of these things may seem kind of complicated, and especially in the beginning it is difficult to remember it all, but don't hesitate to go back to the videos later on if you are going to work on your own project. Now we have two steps to take, and then that should be sufficient to have a real strong basis for using Cubase. The one thing that I'm going to explain now is the use of effects channels and the track sense. And in the next video, I will explain the group channels. And then I think the most, then you know about the most stuff that you need. It will not get more complicated than that. Okay, let's see what we can do with an effects channel. Now, first of all, to recap, so if we have this audio track here with the vocals, we edit the channel, then we could add all these different plugins to our vocals. So, for example, we had a stereo delay here that added an echo to the vocal. Now, normally, so this is not wrong to do, perfectly fine. So if you want to do it like this, then go ahead. But normally you put delays and reverbs and also some other plugins on a separate effects track, because it allows you to have more control, and you get a little bit more flexibility also in manipulating the output of such plugin. Okay, so let's disable this one. We will come back to it. Let us first now add an effects track. So that is easy. I think you know how to do it. We click the plus, and then we select effects track here. And what we do, we select the same delay. So we had the stereo delay that we also had on the insert slot. So that is the effect that we select. Again, a stereo configuration. It goes to the stereo out. It is created outside the folder, but that's not important for now. And we can give it a name and just let's call it delay. And then we say add track, and then you see that this effects track is added. Now, you know, I normally put that at the end of all the tracks, but you can also leave it where it was. We can give it a color. So normally I will make it pink, so that I directly can see that it is an effects track, but it's also indicated, of course, there. And this track is not different from an audio track, but we cannot put an audio event here. So here we have an audio event. We cannot put that on the effects track. Instead, we must have the output of this audio track as input for the effects track. Now, how do we do that? It's very simple, and that is where the sense come in. So we go back to our vocal track, we edit again, and now on the left hand side we see the send. So on the left hand side we had the inserts with the stereo delay, but I disabled this one. But here on the right side we have sends. And the send is nothing more than an output of the audio event, so just the vocal sound. And we can click on this and then say, well, we send the audio to the delay. So this is our effects channel. And then we enable this. So we can again disable and enable. You can also do something with the level, but let's just leave it at 0 dB. And now what we have done is that this audio will be sent to a delay. Now, Let's also do in just in this example add a second effects channel. So we first close this one, we do plus, we select the effects again, and now also let's add a reverb. So we see that that is here, and let's just add Revelation. That is one of the reverbs that comes with Cubase. Enter name, and we call this reverb. And then we say add track, there it is again. Normally put it at the bottom, just drag it with the mouse. I give it a color, and there it is. Now we go back to the audio track again, because I also want to send the audio to the new reverb track. So I edit the audio. It was already sent to the delay, but now I also want to send this to the reverb track. So I click on it, I select reverb, and I enable this. So now the audio of this vocal is sent to the delay and to the reverb. And we can now remove the channel editor. So what we do now, let's now open the lower zone. And now you see that these tracks, these effects tracks for delay and reverb, are also appearing in the mix console. Also in the larger mix console that you may have on your screen. So let's open that as well. So we go to Studio and then Mix Console, or just press F3 if it is not already open. And then we have the larger mix console. And what we now see is that, so we can make the channels a little bit wider. So this is our vocal. And we see that it is now sent to the delay and to the reverb. So you see that also the sends are shown in the mix console. So it is sent to the delay and reverb track. And on the delay track we had a stereo delay plugin. So that was the one that we already have seen in the previous video. So if you click on it, you get this plugin again. And on the reverb track, we have the Revelation plugin. And that is this one. And also here we can select different presets. So let's take an, let's see, what do we have? A large hall, just a hall. Large hole natural. So this is a specific reverb. There are all kinds of parameters that you can change. And what you normally do is that you put the mix level to 100%. So that means that on the effects channel you only have the output of the plugin. Let's check it also for the stereo delay. And there you see that it is between dry. So that means that you would only hear the dry vocal, and the wet vocal is only delay, and we need to put it fully wet. And why are we doing this? Because we have now a vocal, the dry vocal, without delay and reverb, and we have these two effects channels with only delay and reverb, and it's only because we have put it fully to wet. And the Revelation, we have put it also fully to wet, so the mix to 100%. Of course, you can change that if you want, so you can experiment with it, and just to get the sound that you like. But this is a good starting point. You can do nothing wrong. If you like the sound, then it's okay. So let's pull back the faders now. If we now play the audio, so I will close the main window, so we also have it here, but we can also see the inserts if we want. Let's go back to the faders. I will play the audio. Kinda stupid, 'cause I'm in the deep end. So you don't hear any delay or reverb. And it's also because we disabled it in, on the insert slot. So if you would enable it here again. Then you hear the delay, but that is coming from the insert. Now, we disable the insert, so now we only hear the dry vocal. It is sent to the effects channel for the delay and the effects channel for the reverb. But we don't hear it yet, because we have put the faders to zero. Now, let's put the fader up and play the clip again. Kind of crazy. So there is the echo again. But now it is under this fader, and now you can control the amount of delay that you want with this fader. So that's already more easy to control. But we can, for example, now also say, okay, we have a dry vocal that is balanced to the center. And now we want to have the delay only on our left speaker. So we can change the panner all the way to the left. And now if we play it again, we will have it only on our left. But let's also change the preset. Let me see, what did we have? We had huge delay. Let's change to another one, long vocal line, but still put it to red. Again, close this one, go back to the faders. Now we will only have the delay on the left channel. Kind of stupid because I'm in the deep end. Kind of love it, kind of crazy. Now you probably hear that. And we can do the same for the reverb. So we also had it added a reverb. So now we set the level of the delay to zero, and we increase the level of the reverb. Kinda stupid because I'm in the deep end. Kinda love it. So you hear the reverb clearly, and you can adjust the amount just by using the fader. And now we can say, okay, let's do a combination of both. So we can put in a little bit of reverb and maybe lots of delay and play. Kinda crazy, kinda stupid because I'm in the deep end. So by using different effects channels, you can make a mix of the dry vocals together with the processed vocals, in this case the delay and reverb, and that gives you more control. But there is more that you can do. So let's put the delay to zero so that we don't hear it. We only have reverb. Let's play it again. So that is with the reverb, and now we can also edit this channel. So we can open this, and we have here the plugin for the reverb, and we can now also do equalization on the output of this reverb. So we can, for example, enable this band and boost, let's say, the frequency around 2000 hertz. So then only not the dry vocal will be equalized, but only the delay. And we can also say, well, maybe we want to change the pitch of the delay a little bit. So let's go back to this pitch shift that we already have seen earlier and transpose that again to 7, what if we did the last time. So close it. So now what will happen? So we will have reverb, but that will be the pitch of the reverb will be increased, but not the pitch of the dry vocal. And that will then be, and then we will have a boost of 6 decibels for 2000 Hz. Okay, let's play the track again. In the deep end, kinda love it, kinda crazy, kinda stupid. So you hear that now it is like that there are two vocals singing, the main vocal and then another backing vocal, as you wish, with a little bit higher higher pitch. Now this is how you use effects channels. And you can do very creative things with it. You can do it, you know, you can make much more complex routings. You can add more plugins. Also, you can send it even to yet another effects channel, etc. So you can make it as complex as you wish. And then still, in addition to the effects channels, you can still also enable, let's say, the stereo delay on your insert slots. So let's play. So you can use all these plugins in different ways on the inserts and together with the effects channels. And that should then give you the sound that you are after. Okay, just try it yourself. Play around with these effect channels and put some plugins on the insert slots. Put some plugins also on the insert slots of the effect channels, just to see what you can do with this. Okay.